The role of an ETL, for extract, transform, load, is to consolidate data from the information system through three actions. These three actions are contained within its acronym. E for extract. This step involves identifying and extracting data from multiple heterogeneous sources, including files, applications, or databases, for example. Next is the T for transform. This means cleaning and standardizing the data, defining a common format and storage mode for all, removing duplicates, anomalies, and unusable data. The goal at this stage is to convert the data into a usable format. Modern ETL tools offer real-time capabilities to support near-instant data, updates, and analysis. Then, these data are sorted and grouped for the final step, load. The ETL loads this processed data into a target destination, which is often a data warehouse. The ETL thus centralizes all the data in one place. In this data warehouse, the data stored in the databases are accessible through queries and enable the execution of business intelligence data analyses. Users, often from various business domains, can create reports from the data in the data warehouse to facilitate their decision-making. Another primary use case of an ETL is data migration from an old information system to a new information system. ETL processes are used to extract data from the old systems, transform it as needed to fit the new system structure, and then load it into the target system. This allows the new system to have usable data very quickly. Examples of ETL solutions include Apache NIFE, Talend, Informatica Power Center, AWS Glue, and Apache Kafka. Now let's move on to ELT, which is a variant of ETL. ELT, which stands for Extract, Load, and Transform, also extracts data from one or multiple sources. However, the key difference is in the next step, as it loads the data directly onto a target platform without performing any transformation on the data. Since there is no upfront processing, the data ingestion process with ELT is much faster than with ETL. ELT is increasingly being adopted for real-time data integration use cases. ELT has become very popular with the advent of the cloud, because the cloud offers rapid access to storage that is both nearly unlimited and highly scalable. This allows organizations to ingest data quickly, ideally as soon as it becomes available, without needing to determine its use initially. ELT often goes hand in hand with a data lake, which is a large data repository that can store a vast amount of raw data, up to several exabytes. Data lakes offer flexibility in storing raw data, allowing organizations to explore and transform data as needed, which can be particularly advantageous for advanced analytics and machine learning initiatives. It can also involve storing data in an intermediary storage in the cloud, often object storage such as AWS S3, Azure Blob Storage, or Google Cloud Storage. Transformation occurs only when necessary, often on demand and based on specific analysis requirements. For example, for data analysis, big data, or machine learning processing, or for cloud data warehousing like Snowflake, AWS Redshift, Google BigQuery, or Azure Synapse Analytics. Examples of ELT solutions often include AWS Glue, Microsoft Azure Data Factory, Google Cloud Data Flow, and Talend. We've reached the end of this video. I hope it was informative and enjoyable. If you want to keep up with the latest in tech and computer science, don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. Goodbye.